Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I have created this tutorial to show you how we can automate our horizontal slider by using Timer library. But before this, I would recommend to go through my previously created videos on horizontal slide. There you will be learning how to create a slider using iOS native UI scroll view component. In the description of this tutorial, you can find the link of videos related to a slider. I'm using following configuration of system: macOS Mojave version 10.14.3, Swift version 5, Xcode version 10.2.1, and Simulator version 10.2.1. Let's get started. First of all, we will see that what changes we are going to make in this app. I have added one text field which will be accepting seconds and then the two button. The one is to start the timer and the other one is to stop our timer. Let's see that how all these three elements are working. I will mention 2 here, so 2 means the 2 second time interval. So it will take the slider will move ahead after 2 seconds. So we'll start by clicking on this button. So here you can see that after 2 seconds, after each 2 seconds, the slider is getting moved. Okay, then we will stop moving the slider and then we move back to the previous, and then again we go to that button and then click here start button. And if we stop here, then our timer got stopped. So in this way this functionality is working. Let's see how the backend code is working or is working and how the action is working. So I'm assuming that you already know how we can add text fill element and start and end button over the storyboard or over the scene. If you don't know, then please go through my previous videos. In that I have shown that how we can add that or how we can create an IB outlets and IB actions for these items. Let's see. Let's move to our code. I will click on assistant editor. We'll hide this. So this is it. Yeah, so this one is the IB outlet for my text field, TXT timer, and this one is the timer instance, scroll timer, and these two are the IB actions for the start button and the end button. End timer is the IB action for end button, and the start timer is an IB action for the start button. So you already know that we have created an instance of scroll timer. Now we will schedule our timer on the click of start button. Let's see how we can do that. So as we click on start button, this start action get executed, and before this execution we will going to invalidate, and this invalidate function releases the memory from the scroll timer object, and it means that it stops the timer. And here we will be storing our input. that from the text field into str string timer, and then we are typecasting it into a double. So this method of timer class we will be using scheduled timer here, and it accepts four parameters. So one is the time interval, and here we're going to pass our typecasted value that we accepted from the timer, and then the target self, and then the selector, and then the selector is actually a method which will going to be executed on the each interval. Like if we selected two as an interval for the scheduled timer, then after each 2 seconds, this method will going to be executed. So if you want to repeat this, then we will going to set it as true. Otherwise, we will set it as a false. Suppose like if you want to execute any piece of code at once, then you have to select false here. You have to pass false here. So this is how our start timer action will be, and in the end timer we will just write a scroll timer dot invalidate. And I also added code for how to change the keyboard type. So I want that keyboard type should be should accept only or should have only a decimal pad. So decimal pad means that it will have only keys related to decimals. So this is it, and this is how we are going to hide our keyboard when we will going to tap anywhere on the screen. So this is it, and let's see that what does this method contains. And I have created an extension for UIView controller, and here you will see hide keyboard when tabbed around method. And I just created an instance for tab, that is for UI tabs gesture recognizer, and it will recognize, or it will call it this dismiss keyboard when a user will click on anywhere on the screen, and it will dismiss the keyboard. So this is what we are doing to hide our keyboard. And the other thing I would like to mention, that there was a bouncing issue, and I also fixed that. And let's see that what was that. So in my earlier code, it was the content size was taking my view height. So you can see that some space above the screen, and if we click on this, then it moves ahead, it moves upward direction, and here you can see that there is a bouncing effect. So we can fix that also. To fix that, we will be setting content size to the width of the scroll view. Sorry, not width, height of the scroll view. So this is it. And after executing this code, we will see that there is no more bouncing effect issue. So this is how, yeah, so we fixed that bouncing effect issue. So I hope you like this video. You can provide feedback, and if you want anything else in the slider, if you want anything else in the modification, then you can comment me, you can suggest me, and I will try to resolve or fix that issue in my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching me. Keep coding.